Really don't know why we're playing with suits on, but down, set, hike! Get open! This is movie night! Hello and welcome to Movie Night, YouTube's number one most viewed movie review show. I'm your host, Jonathan Paula. With Super Bowl Sunday just a few days away, tonight's theme will be football pictures. One deals with youth athletes, another with high schoolers, and a third with professionals. We'll begin tonight with the kids in Little Giants. Released in October of 1994, this family-friendly sports comedy film by director Dwayne Dunham failed to recoup its $20 million budget at the box office. But having watched it multiple times on VHS as a kid, I have to imagine it did much better on home video. Inspired by a 1990s McDonald's Super Bowl ad, Rick Moranis and Ed O'Neill, at the height of both of their respective careers, star as two competitive brothers in a small Ohio town obsessed with football, who essentially have a contest as to who can coach the better Pee-wee team. Playing the perfectly awkward but lovable dork, Moranis guides a band of misfit reject children to the film's climactic big game, showing them that everyone deserves a chance. O'Neill is terrific at balancing the stereotypical bad guy traits with the charming uncle and brother side of his character. Long before safety concerns and regulations exposed youth sports as dangerous, this 106-minute film paints a nostalgic look at team spirit, football, and the classic American community. The basic exposition is overtly spoon-fed to the audience, with O'Neill speeding away in a shiny new sports car with boastful vanity plates. Because if it wasn't clear already, he's a big hotshot and there's no way his hand-picked team will lose to Moranis' ragtag team of goofy little kids. The featured child actors are all adorable and undeniably entertaining. From a junk food hungry kid who farts at everyone, to a sheltered child who explodes with rage when you threaten his mom. Their character personalities and story arcs are all extremely juvenile and rudimentary, but they provide for some great laughs. Early 90s heartthrob Devon Sawa isn't given much to do except look pretty, but his on-screen crush, Shauna Waldron, turns in an excellent performance as the hard-tackling tomboy who finds herself at odds with her feminine feelings. A scene with Waldron and Moranis, both afraid to introduce themselves to their respective love interests, is amusing and endearing. The visual cinematography and music are never impressive, but they're competently accomplished. This PG adventure moves quickly, providing many hilarious moments. Especially Moranis' inspirational one-time halftime speech.
Wait a second, guys. Whoever said you had to be good to play football? You play football because you want to. You play football because it's fun. You play football so you can go out there and pretend that you're Joe Montana throwing a touchdown pass or Emmitt Smith going for a long run. And even if those Cowboys are better than you guys, even if they beat you 99 times out of 100, that still leaves
one time.
Or a montage featuring all of the little giants psyching themselves up the night before the big game. A second act cameo sequence by John Madden, Emmitt Smith, and other NFL legends is interesting enough, but feels especially out of place and forced, and honestly, most kids probably won't know who they are anyway. And other background characters, like O'Neill's assistant coach or two elderly men who bet on the Pee Wee contest, are completely dropped from the script halfway through. These issues aren't likely to detract from any enjoyment, but they're a sign of poor execution and the film's directorial change midway during shooting. The sensationalized story is a great time for the entire family, and one I'll have no problem watching with my kids someday. Little Giants, classic family comedy, supremely memorable. That was my review, now let's read some of yours from the YouTube comments. The Rate-O-Matic with Little Giants, a 7 and a 7. You applauded the kid-friendly humor and the good-natured laughs, but faulted this film for being a bit too predictable. You rated it cool. I completely agree. This is a picture I truly loved as a kid, and it holds up remarkably well today, but it's hardly a masterpiece by any means. I think it's cool as well. Next up tonight is Any Given Sunday. Opening with a pointless and generic quote from famed Green Bay Packers coach Vince Lombardi, this Oliver Stone American sports drama was released a week before Y2K, and almost doubled its $55 million budget. Oscar winner and perpetual yeller Al Pacino leads a massively talented ensemble cast, which quite frankly features some of the worst performances of their successful careers. His character does little more than moan and grunt at the other actors, propelling the few bits of exposition this picture does have with unashamed bluntness. Dennis Quaid, Cameron Diaz, James Woods, Jamie Foxx, LL Cool J, and Aaron Eckhart all chew through the dialogue with such anger and resentment, it's almost as if they're fully aware this film is emotionally empty. Ostensibly, this film follows Foxx, a third-string quarterback who quickly rises to fame and success both on and off the field. but it's hard to root for such a greedy, disrespectful, and narcissistic character who shows little depth or remorse for his selfish actions.
Feel like throwing up?
No, why not?
Last time you puked, you had a hell of a game.
Yeah, you make a ritual out of it,
people are going to respect you for it.
We're going to go at him,
and we'll go with the spirit. That's what I want from you. Come on. Focus.
All right, cool.
Concentration.
Yeah.
Downfield. Every inch. You see it before you do it. You see it, you do it.
All right, I got it. I feel it. Coach, I'm just wondering why y'all was taking so long. We about to let this one slip away.
Well, then go ahead. Let's go.
All right.
Make me a believer!
14-3 Chicago, second quarter, 3 minutes left.
Meanwhile, the veteran Quaid is literally and figuratively sidelined for most of the picture, given little to do but complain in the background. At a painfully long 2 hours and 42 minutes, this fast-moving but still extremely bloated motion picture is presented with jittery close-ups, overused slow motion, repeat shots, and it's all stitched together with hyperkinetic editing, featuring over 3,000 cuts in total. As if Stone was suffering from ADHD while high on cocaine, the almost nauseating execution is entirely unmotivated and immensely distracting, making the few moments of genuine enjoyment in this picture a chore to experience. Unable to secure the rights to any real logos or uniforms, this pro football story features a pathetically fictional AFFA league with goofy names like the Albuquerque Aztecs and the Houston Cattlemen, which all make it rather difficult to take this picture seriously. One ridiculous scene has a nameless background player releasing a live alligator into the locker room. I suppose this scene is supposed to endear us to the undeveloped team's fun-loving antics, but honestly, it just seemed incredibly unbelievable, stupid, and irresponsible, to say nothing of the fact that it wasn't even funny. The occasional touchdown drive is momentarily exciting, but for a film that focuses far too much on the football without providing any context or character development, it's hard to stay invested. A hurried epilogue all but glosses over the fact that the team ends up losing the big championship game anyway, cheating the audience out of a proper ending. When the film slows down just long enough, the wide anamorphic frame provides for some nice shots, with bright colors and vivid details. But with an uninteresting and boring script, constant swears and shouting, and a bland soundtrack, this R-rated picture is rarely dramatic or enjoyable. A film I practically forgot even before the end credits were over, this is a huge waste of talent I don't think I'll ever watch again. Hardcore NFL fans or those fond of the uniform customization options in football video games might find something to enjoy here, but honestly, Any Given Sunday is colossally tepid, barely redeemable thrills. Well, that was my scathing review. Now let's see what you had to say about this picture in the YouTube comments. Any Given Sunday, a 5 and a 2. Of the limited reviews, your feelings were mixed. Some enjoyed the performances, but you bemoaned the long runtime and boring delivery. You thought it was just all right. The unrealistic plot and hyper-distracting presentation was annoying, and the plot lacked any real depth or memorable moments. Definitely not a picture I'd recommend watching, and a surprise disappointment from Stone, who's usually far more capable. I thought this film was bad. Now, a quick word from our sponsor. With MoviePass, you can see 30 movies in theaters for $30 a month. And since most pictures will set you back $10 or more, that's a hell of a savings, especially if you see just a few of the awesome pictures slated for release this February. So help support Movie Night and save yourself $10 off your first month with my exclusive invite by visiting moviepass.com/jogwheel. Lastly tonight, let's review Remember the Titans. This Walt Disney period sports drama that meshes a compelling sports narrative with a look at race relations during the Civil Rights era was a financial success, earning over $100 million in profit when it was released in September of 2000. Director Boaz Yakin paints a dramatic and moving image of 1970s Virginia, when one community is forced to integrate their white and black football programs, and to the surprise of many, proved to be one of the best teams to play the game. Two-time Academy Award winner Denzel Washington is the stubborn perfectionist who must lead the bickering high schoolers to victory in a community where, quote, high school football is a way of life. In a dark period of our history dealing with outstanding circumstances, Washington is an uncompromising, self-described dictator who ignores the racist community around him and pushes his athletes to win in one of the actor's many great performances.
Gary, if you want to play on this football team, you answer me when I ask you, who is your daddy? Who's your daddy, Gary?
You.
Uh-huh. And whose team is this? Is this your team, or is this your daddy's team?
Yours.
Mm-hmm. Get on the bus. Put your jacket on first, and get on the bus. Dean? Fix that tie, son.
Although historical accuracy is sacrificed for tension, The events here are based on a true story and represent an overt microcosm of the white-black turmoil America was experiencing at the time. Although this unoriginal plot does very little to break the extremely formulaic mold, it hits all of the right beats and is immensely enjoyable and rewarding doing so. At 113 minutes, this PG film balances the struggles of equality with the struggles on the gridiron perfectly, and Trevor Rabin's swelling theme makes for some truly effective moments both on and off the field. This instantly recognizable score is meshed adeptly with iconic rock anthems of the late 1960s that truly capture the mood in many key montages and sequences. The cast of familiar faces, but perhaps less familiar names, includes Will Patton, Wood Harris, Ryan Hurst, Donald Faison, Ethan Suplee, Hayden Panettiere, Kate Bosworth, and a young Ryan Gosling, all of whom blend expertly into their characters. Antagonist conflict is shoehorned into the story by way of cookie-cutter racists, who only serve to cheapen an otherwise decent script. Early, the passive-aggressive racism by the white players is only matched by the sarcastic condescension of the black players. But as they learn to become friends, a truly magical thing happens, and it's hard not to smile during this uplifting and inspirational adventure. Resembling a sort of paint-by-numbers drama, a bit of the spoon-fed conflict can feel particularly heavy-handed at times, and many of the dramatic turns are more than predictable. There are a few shallow payoffs late that deliver little gratification, as the story arcs they're concluding were barely throwaway lines of dialogue from an hour earlier. Analogous to the similar gay rights discrimination this country is still facing today, I couldn't help but be disheartened by this picture's hopeful message of tolerance and understanding. Here we are, 40 years later, and we still don't have true equal rights in this country. An excellent family drama that even non-sports fans can enjoy in multiple viewings, Remember the Titans is instantly inspiring with familiar execution. Now that you've heard my review, let's see what you had to say in the YouTube comments. Here's how we scored Remember the Titans, a 9 and an 8. You love Denzel's performance and praise this picture's inspiring story, emotional delivery, and accessible football scenes, scoring it an awesome. A feel-good adventure that was a bit too by-the-book Disney-esque to score any higher, I still felt this was an entertaining movie with an important script. I thought it was great. Lastly tonight, let's check out what's currently playing in theaters with some of your tweet critiques. If you see a new movie in theaters, make sure to submit your Twitter review using the JPMN hashtag to have it featured on the show. Next week, we'll talk zombies. We'll review the 2002 horror film from Danny Boyle, 28 Days Later, the 2004 British comedy with Simon Pegg, Shaun of the Dead, and Warm Bodies, the quirky romantic comedy that's brand new in theaters. Let me know what you think about these movies by voting in the polls below or by leaving a comment review. And remember to check out the Movie Night Archive for an organized library of all our past reviews. Once again, my name is Jonathan Paula. Thank you for watching Movie Night. Have a great time watching the Super Bowl this Sunday, and I hope to see you right back here next Friday.